Quiddler represents the only lineup change today, as here's Filppula trying to tuck it by the goaltender on the rebound, and it would not go. The pad of Kiprusoff prevailed on that one. Although if this lives up to Pierre's prediction, we'll see more of the roughing sort of penalties and the heavy hits today, but here's a two-on-one. It's brought back ahead for Sean. Oh, and Hudson, a wonderful save on Jeff Friesen.
Ed, you can't pitch down if you're Markov in this situation.
Who's probably tired of us saying he's 45. Down to the ice went Robert Lang.
If you take a look in behind Mika Kiprusoff.
And then one of the reasons why they'd be so upset, they know Detroit wants to get bodies on net.
Datsyuk's shot went wide. Maltby reached that one, scaled it behind to Datsyuk again. Maltby moving to the front, but he's taken right out of the play by Dion Phaneuf.
Back-to-back hits by Phaneuf on Datsyuk, and then Maltby on Conroy.
Turnaround whip by Lebda, and it's cleared back for the shot by Chelios. That is grabbed and held by Kiprusoff, and he's complaining to Don Koharski. Hands it over to Lebda. Schneider the shot, and that one blocked out. Lombardi charges away. Can he get loose? Lombardi in on Hasek. Save Hasek! Both teams get a man back now. Datsyuk shot save. Rebound! Oh, and it wouldn't go through. It's stepping in the way with Brad Stewart.
Thought process, shoot the puck if you're Detroit.
It is Schneider shooting. Getting that one is Kiprusoff through a screen. Intensity is right. Lang moving in. Oh, and a Kiprusoff with a block there. Andre Zuzan tried to get that. Daniel Cleary did. Fed it back around for a backhander. Front save. Rebound. A penalty was coming up. No light on.
No goal. They're going to call goalie interference, and I don't know.
I totally disagree with this call. Maltby's going in. He's trying to avoid. Kiprusoff goes down.
Result, you see Cleary up ice on Hamrick. Watch how aggressive they are on the penalty kill this afternoon.
What great work by Daniel Cleary to chew some more time off the clock. Here's a feed that is taken around now, and circling with it is Bronson. Shook one in front, directed on goal, save. Rebound, and it would not go. It's a tie match, and so Lidstrom stepped into him. A chance for Amati, wobble boarded away, and a rebound is knifed away. Huselius has regained that side. Huselius fed it, drive by Tenge. Huselius a shot, remarkable play at the front of the net by Hasek. He just flexed up high in the air. The last two power plays of the period belonged to Calgary, and Detroit killed them off. And a little wrestling match at the end of the period between Aginla and Chelios. Brett Warner moved in with a little bit of a shove, too. Back to get it now is Schneider. Schneider able to pitchfork it along. It's careened off Hamrelick. Coming by is Cleary. Hamrelick trying to get back. Daniel Cleary accelerates on in. Getting a piece of it. Kiprusoff. It went to the glass. What do we got? Penalty shot. Everyone is standing as Cleary takes the puck, has to keep in a continuous motion, moving on in, score!
Well, Daniel Cleary has the puck in a shooting position. Kiprusoff goes for the poke check, and Cleary, forehand, backhand. But the positioning on the stick, keeping the goaltender honest, could shoot it every time.
Coming by Holmstrom, but Zetterberg took. Look for Datsyuk in front, then shot one. Oh, and a great stop made in front by Kiprusoff. And that is a linesman's ball, is it not?
Yes.
This particular moment in this series.
Very much so.
Oh, Holmstrom with a mash of a hit there. Just getting back to his feet is Stewart, as this is held by Schneider. Handed across to Lidstrom, and then Zetterberg scores!
Perfect pass, Nicholas Lidstrom to Henrik Zetterberg. Thomas Holmstrom, I believe that went right between the legs of Holmstrom and then in behind Kiprusoff.
And the crowd buzzing here as a player is down right near the Red Wings bench.
Wow, this is bad. Danny Cleary came under his own duress right into the ball, right here in front of me. Nobody's around him. He just falls right down. But he's up, and he's leaving the ice on his own, moving his extremities, and that's obviously real good news for the Red Wings and their fans and the Cleary family. Hartley's got to start getting some pucks and Dominic Kashuk.
Here's Bertuzzi, a long save, Kiprusoff! Bronson couldn't take it, Hammerly could on Natatenge with a shot that slowed down, sprawling is Hasek, and the puck is underneath him, and now he's mad. After the whistle, the puck crossed the line, and before that, Tempers crossed the line.
Let's see if Calgary makes that in-game adjustment of using the points, getting shots from the points that are trying to make their cute little plays down low.
Not a great start. As the Red Wings bring it in, Chelios wanted it, and he fired, he scores!
And what you gotta watch is a turnover, and watch Chelios read and react and jump in. Maybe his offensive game hasn't dissipated, Ed. Maybe it's as strong as ever for Chris Chelios.
Third shorthanded career goal for Chris Chelios.
Chris Chelios.
Lidstrom takes care of his man. Now Aginla, back to Tange again. They creep in, Aginla drive, getting a piece of it, Hasek. Tange there, put up a shot, off of Hasek, who sprawled after that one hit him. Put up a drive, off the iron! Got the glass and hopped onto Maltby. Stepped in two with authority by Conroy.
Good to see Cleary back on the ice.
Knocked the man down, Cleary, with the winning goal scored by a man named Olchek. Noin. A turning take by Datsyuk. Save made by Kiprusoff. And Draper played to Markov, and Cleary, oh, was he ever run down at the horn, and a crowd gathers as Giordano got in a good hit on it. But there's a limit even for a young man and how much here. Oh, and that one popped off of Hasek and nearly rattled in, but went off the pipe.
That Zetterberg power play goal was something else, so that's a highlight reel power play goal.
It was terrific. Is that the one that turned the game, or was the penalty shot goal? Zetterberg again, he scores! They're raising their sticks, the light is on, and it's 4-0. This is Cleary, oh, and that one caused Kiprusoff to tumble over backwards. There was a time, as down to the ice goes Nick Lidstrom, and off the ice will come Aginla, and they have some words and bump one another. Ahead with this now shorthanded is Conroy with a man breaking. Lombardi got it to him. Oh, what a stop by Hasek! As tumbling across was Lepta. Conroy holding again, back to Lombardi, drive, score! A short now, they're gonna wave it off. The light is on and the referee was signaling with his arms out.
The Islanders just were not in the same building, but you know, the Islanders showed so much resiliency, different type of series, no question about it.
We have a player down and we have a challenge issued.
Knuff and Cleary jot all the way back up the ice. And that's been the matchup. Cleary's always gone after Knuff. Jerome Aginla going after Cleary. Lanco and Ledda get engaged. Now there's a hit on Cleary. Now remember, he's been dishing out some big ones. And they just challenge one another well all the way up the ice.
8:35 to go, third period. The hip check is what took the 22s down. 4-1 Detroit. Oh! Calgary get a power play on the Lepta clip, and Lankow got away with one seriously. He is not penalized.
He doesn't trust Holmstrom out there.
Especially now that he's a target, he doesn't want him to take a penalty.
Oh my goodness, Knuff went down as leaning into him was Datsyuk. Moving on as Bronson dumped one wide, and Amonte with the touch, the Red Wings with the power play, and Lankow to the box.
Well, Todd Bertuzzi.
And we got action here. Kirk Maltby, Jeff Friesen. They're challenging one another. Jerome McGinley right now talking to the Detroit Red Wings. You guys want to run Kiprusoff? We'll start going after your guy. The blood boiling right now is unbelievable between the two benches.
Running, when were they running Kiprusoff? Early in the game or just right now, Pierre?
I think it goes back to earlier in the game.
All right.
So they didn't get him initially on Lehto, but they got him eventually. Lidstrom holds and a blast went wide. That shoot scores out the rebound. This is back to Lilja. Spun back on now for Bronson. Out of the glove of Kiprusoff, and another penalty coming up for slashing to Calgary.
Well, the damage has been done. And now Calgary's frustrated, and they're just trying to send messages now for game six.
Well, exactly in game one and two, Pierre. Yep. Same thing. Take a penalty, yep. Frustration.
Yep.
Enough's enough.
And you know what I think? I think Jamie McClellan's going to go in goal for Calgary. I think they don't want Kiprusoff to get hurt. And this is smart by Calgary.
At NBCSports.com.
McClellan's going to get a penalty here, slashing Johan Franzen. Not very smart by Jamie McClellan.
Again, obviously, the frustration was, oh my God!
Oh, what is he doing?
Oh my gosh!
Well, that was just an
oh, no,
what is
just,
he doing?
That's imbecilic.
They throw him right out. That's it.
Oh,
Kiprusoff will be back in.
Yeah, and they don't have a backup goal. They're going to have to get a back. He's going to get suspended for that. That's insane. That's crazy.
Well, even though it seemed like a good choice at the time, it was a terrible move.
Yeah, no, that's terrible. That's so out of character for him. That is bizarre.
Unacceptable, Pierre. It doesn't matter if it's out of character. Unacceptable.
Oh, I agree. This is reprehensible. This is terrible. And senseless.
Two for slash, five for slash, and a game misconduct.
These two teams go back to Calgary, and we got a 10.
Oh,
what do we got now?
On Schneider, again on Schneider. Two in a row. One was a butt end, one's a cross check.
Obviously into the playoffs, two home games. Now Nielsen's giving a cross check to Draper.
What is this?
This is unbelievable.
Well, somewhere along the line, somebody has to say, look, enough.
And the thing is, you know Detroit had the fewest fighting majors of any team in the NHL this year. They're not like that. That's not their team.